गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 2 फॉर क्लास 12th सब्जेक्ट इंग्लिश फॉर द पोयम अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी कंपोज्ड बाय जॉन कीट्स टेकन फ्रॉम योर मेन कोर्स बुक फ्लेमिंगो. चिल्ड्रन, येस्टरडे इन लेक्चर नंबर 1 ऑफ दिस पोयम आई टोल्ड यू अबाउट द पोएट जॉन कीट्स. देन आई गेव यू इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस पोयम and then I explained the complete poem line by line and I told you all the literary devices used by the poet in the poem and then I assigned you homework. Children, today in this lecture number 2 of the same poem, I will recapitulate all 4 stanzas of the poem for your better understanding and then we will proceed towards the textual exercise which has 7 questions of the poem. And then at last I'll assign you homework. Okay children, let's begin with the recapitulation of the poem A Thing of Beauty. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bar quiet for us and a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and quiet breathing. So children, in these lines, the poet John Keats tells us that the beauty stays forever. You need to keep it in your mind that he is not talking about external beauty. He is not talking about the beauty which is not permanent, which is temporary. In this, actually he talks about the beauty that gives us an unending joy. So you can understand, no materialistic beauty can give us an unending joy because the things which are born today have to die one day. All the living beings also have to die one day. So he says that the beauty can't be attained which will provide an unending source of joy from all the materialistic things present in the world. So what does he mean when he talks about a thing of beauty is a joy forever? He says, a thing of beauty is actually the deeds that we are performing in our human form and we are sent to this world with a special purpose. If in order to keep the mankind alive, we are performing good deeds. And whenever we remind that good deed performed by us will be providing us an unending joy. That joy will be forever. That will make us feel proud that we did something good to keep the mankind alive. Being humans, we spread humanity. Therefore, now let's begin. He says that the thing of beauty is a joy forever. And the loveliness of this beauty keeps on increasing. That never fades away, that never pass into nothingness. Nothingness means a thing of no value, a thing of zero value. So he says that the beauty we are attaining from our good deeds will provide us a joy that will be unending. And the loveliness of that joy will keep on increasing with every reminder of the same deed. And that deed will never pass. The value of that thing will never be zero. That will be valuable forever. And it will keep a bar. Bar means a shady place under the tree. That will keep a bar quiet for us. And in fact, it will provide us a shady place as gives us if we are sitting under a tree. Then we feel that we are blessed with the shade that is provided by the tree. In the same manner, after performing a good deed, we feel as if we are in the shade of some good deed. So that provides us quiet breathing. Therefore, on every morrow, morrow means morning, are we wreathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth? Spite of despondence, of the inhumane dearth of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and o'er-darkened ways, made for our searchings, yes, in spite of all, some shape of beauty moves away the pall. In these lines, you need to understand what does the poet want to convey. As in the first stanza, he wrote, a thing of beauty is an unending source of joy, and its loveliness keeps on increasing every day, and that never passes into nothingness. Therefore, the poet is asking us, on every morrow, means on every morning, are we reading? Reading means viewing. Are we viewing a flowery band to bind us to this earth? We are originated from earth. We are connected to this earth because this earth is the medium of our survival. The poet asks us, in order to keep your survival possible in a healthy manner, are you performing good deeds which are connecting you to this motherland? That is earth. He says, are we viewing a flowery band? Flowery band here means the band of good deeds. If I am doing something good to others, then that other fellow will do something good to others. So in such a way, a chain, a band of flowers will be created by us, will be viewed by us. So the poet says, in order to connect ourselves to this motherland, are we paying heed to the actions that we are performing in our day-to-day life, whether those actions of ours are connecting us to this motherland or they are departing us from there? Then the poet raises a very good question. He says, spite of despondence. Spite means malice. Malice in Hindi means dvesh. Spite of despondence. Despondence means disappointments, depressions. He says, in this human form, we have noticed there is a spite of despondence, there is dearth of human nature, noble nature. Dearth means lack of. He says, of the inhuman dearth of noble natures, humans are becoming inhumans because there is lack of noble nature in humans. And then he says, there are gloomy days. Gloomy means sad. There are sad days also in our life. And there are unhealthy and darkened ways. Means there are many humans present on this earth, those who are running a rat race to get more and more. Therefore, in order to satisfy their desires or expectations, they are using unhealthy or wrong ways in order to achieve the mottos of their lives. And their desires are endless. So the poet says that there is a spite of despondence. There is malice due to disappointments. Humans are with lack of noble nature. Therefore, we have to face many times sad days. Then we are running a rat race to get more and more by using unhealthy or darkened ways. He says all such things are present in the world. Why? Then he begins or the answers this question in the next line. He says these things are made for our searching. Made for our searching means these things and such bad people and the people full of evils are also present on this land in order to show us the mirror. And we must learn a lesson from such poor people that they are performing bad deeds, therefore their end is also in the bad manner. Such the sun, the moon, trees old and young, sprouting a shady boon for simple sheep, and such are daffodils with the green world they live in, and clear rills that for themselves a cooling covert make, gainst the hot season the mid-forest break. In these lines, the poet suggests or describes the beautiful things which are present on earth. These are the sun, the moon, the trees, flowers, daffodils, and the rivers. Here he says they are providing a shady boon. Boon means blessing. The poet says that all these things are like a blessing bestowed on all the creatures by earth. He further describes that the tree provides us with their shade, flowers with their beauty and fragrance, rivers with their coolness during the hot summers. And all of these are the beauties of nature which are like a boon for us. Children, in these lines the poet says that we are blessed with the nature, the sun, the moon, trees, old, young, sprouting a shady boon even for simple sheep. He says when the nature does not discriminate, why do we humans discriminate? The poet says that even the sun, the moon, trees which are old or young, they are also sprouting their blessing, their shady boon. Boon means blessing, even for the simple sheep. And such are the daffodils with the green world. Green world means jungle, forest, where they live in. They are also spreading their fragrance in their surrounding. They also do not differentiate and they give their fragrance to everybody that is close to them. Though they have been living in the jungle, and there the poet says there are clear rills, there are breaks, there are forests, there are trees, and the daffodils are giving their fragrance to all of them. Then the poet gives us the beautiful example of clear rills. Rills are the small streams or the small rivers flowing in the middle of the forest. He gives the example of clear rills to make us understand that when that clear rill can create a cooling cover to protect itself from the hot season. Gainst means against. The poet John Keats says that a clear stream that is running into the middle of the forest irrigates itself onto the both sides of its own, and then they grow up to be the biggest size of their own and provide that clear rill a cooling cover. Rich with a sprinkling of fair musk rose blooms, and such too is the grandeur of the dooms we have imagined for the mighty dead, all lovely tales that we have heard or read, an endless fountain of immortal drink pouring onto us from the heaven's brink. Children, in these lines, you must notice the difficult words with their meanings. Grandeur. Grandeur means high rank or socially important. Mighty. Mighty means enormous, powerful. Immortal. Never dying. Brink. Brink means edge. The poet John Keats in these lines further carries on with the description of the more beautiful things present on this earth, such as the beautiful musk roses which have such a nice fragrance. Then the poet describes the tales of the mighty warriors who laid their lives for their countries or for humanity. He says that these beautiful things are the gifts from God for all of us. They are like a nectar given by God to us, and these are those beauties which are immortal, and they give us a reason to live on this earth despite having so many sorrows in our life. The poet says that the beautiful tales, tales means stories, the beautiful or the lovely tales of our mighty warriors or our powerful warriors always inspire us to start our life as they lived their life. The poet says those lovely tales which we hear or we read inspire us and they motivate us to lead our life despite having so many sorrows in our life. The poet says, those people, there is an endless fountain of immortal drink. Means, those stories are just like a nectar given by God to us because we get inspired. They motivate us to live our life to the fullest and spread mankind, humanity. And we must have to perform the deeds for the welfare of the society. If we are real humans, we will be respecting the mankind and we will be respecting the humanity and we will be performing the deeds for the welfare of society. Therefore, the poet says that all those beautiful things which our powerful warriors did are just like a gift for us from God, which inspire us to live our life to the fullest, not only for self, but for all others as well. So children, that was the complete recapitulation of the poem A Thing of Beauty. And now we will proceed towards the textual exercise given in your book. Question number 1 in your book of this poem is, list the things of beauty mentioned in the poem. So you would have noticed the poet John Keats has given a list of beautiful things in his poem, such as the sun, the moon, shady trees, beautiful daffodil flowers, streams of water, dense green bushes of forest, ferns where fragrant musk roses grow, tales of heroic men who sacrifice their lives, etc. And question number 2 is, list the things that cause suffering and pain. In answer to this question, we can write, the poet John Keats has given the list of things that cause sufferings and pain, such as desire to offend others, hopelessness, lack of noble men, bad health, unhappiness, gloomy days, darkness, unhealthy ways, etc. Question number 3 is, what does the line, therefore, are we reading a flowery band to bind us to the earth, suggest to you? Children, this line means that we get attached to the beautiful things around us and we weave a pretty band which binds us with our life. And it becomes the reason for us to live our life. So the poet is urging in this line to human beings that we must do the act of kindness every day so that we get ourselves connected to our mother earth, motherland, that is earth. Therefore, he is asking a question, are we viewing that band of good deeds which will bind us to our mother earth? Now we will proceed to question number 4, that is, what makes human beings love life in spite of troubles and sufferings? The poet says, in spite of troubles and sufferings, there is some shape of beauty that inspires us to live our life with a new start. The eternal beauty of various things give us happiness and relaxation. It makes us love life in spite of life's troubles and sufferings. So in his poem, he has written, there are so many things made for our searchings, and in spite of all these things, some shape of beauty that removes the pall. Pall means covering from our dark spirits. And we get inspired to live our life again. Question number 5 is, why is grandeur associated with the mighty dead? Children, while explaining the poem, I taught you mighty dead means our powerful warriors, right? And grandeur means magnificence. So the poet is asking how वी कैन अचीव मैग्निफिसेंस ऑफ लाइफ विद द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ आर माइटी डेड्स. सो द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन वुड बी द नोबल डीड्स ऑफ द ब्रेव मेन हु सेक्रीफाइज्ड देयर लाइव्स आर एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर अस फॉर एवर. द ब्यूटिफुल लिगेसी ऑफ देयर ब्रेवरी इज द ग्रैंडवर विच इज एसोसिएटेड विद द माइटी डेड. सो द नोबल डीड्स दे डिड इन देयर ह्यूमन फॉर्म विच आर हर्ड और रेड बाय अस थ्रू देयर डिफरेंट टेल्स ऑफ ब्रेवरी एंड दे इंस्पायर अस टू लिव अ लाइफ नॉट फॉर सेल्फ बट फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ द होल मैनकाइंड. And your question number 6 given in your textbook is, do we experience things of beauty only for short moments or do they make a lasting impression on us? The answer to this question is given by the poet in the very beginning of his poem. According to the poet John Keats, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. And its loveliness increases that never passes into nothingness. Even if we see it for a few moments, it has a lasting impression on us and its beautiful memory stays with us forever. And it inspires us to live despite the ruthlessness of our life. Therefore, we experience things of beauty not for short moments, but they leave a long-lasting impression onto our memories. The last in question number 7 is, what image does the poet use to describe the beautiful bounty of the earth? So the answer to this question is, the beautiful bounty of the earth is described by endless fountain of immortal drink, which signifies that God bestows us with all His beautiful creations, which help us live despite the sad, gloomy aspects of our life. Children, this was the complete explanation of all the 7 questions given in your textbook. I hope you would have understood them. And now I will assign you homework, that is, learn and write all these discussed question answers, which are 7 in number, in your Fair English notebook. And I know that you people have written the summary of this poem in after completing my first lecture in your Fair notebook. And now you are supposed to write all these 7 question answers in your Fair English notebook and keep revising the poem. Thank you. Have a nice day.